Hello everyone, today we will discuss about the introduction of the digital concept. In order to understand the digital concept, we have to understand the few terms that what exactly signal is, what are analog and digital signal, and what are the advantages. In order to understand the term signal, we have to understand these two figures. In one of the figure, two persons are communicating with each other, means there is a transformation of the signal from one person to another, which actually lies in the free space. Another example of signal is given in this GIF, where it is just showing the red and green signal, and according to the signal, an action performed as you see. When it shows the red, then everything stops here. But when it shows green, everything is moving here and there. So overall, crux of the story, or in a nutshell, we can say that the signal is something which helps to convey the information from one place to another, or from one person to another. Next is what is the difference between analog and the digital? Fine. So in order to understand the difference between analog and digital, we have to discuss this. Here, two persons are moving from this zero point to the final point. One person is moving continuously, another one is taking the discrete step. So, in digital, we are just taking the discrete steps. We are not considering the whole range of data. We are just picking and placing some sort of data. But in analog, we are just taking the continuous data over infinite range of values. So if technically, if we see the difference, that analog signal is continuous in nature, which is clearly mentioned in this example of the analog signal. Opposite side, that is discrete in nature, and it is represented by the two logics. One is the high, another one is the low. If you see, this high shows the logic one and zero shows the logic low. Next is the representation. Analog is represented by sine wave and represented by the square wave. Next, that why we prefer analog. Analog signals are having the high precision, and in real time application, everything is analog in nature. We are the one who converts the analog into the digital. If you see this example, there are two temperature measurement devices. One is analog, another one is the digital. In analog, we are taking the value up to the 5 or 6 digits, which means it is showing the high precision rate as compared to the digital. Digital is just rounding off the data and representing the data on the display unit. Next is the digital. In order to understand this, one thing is the reproducibility and not affected by the noise. Are information transmitted in the form of the 1 and 0, and noise mainly affect the amplitude of the signal. So it didn't happen in our case, so that's why it is less affected by the noise as compared to the analog signal. Ease of design, if you see, in order to program, or in order to take the output from the digital data, we have to just program these small ICs. What I program here, it can be displayed on this displaying unit. If you see here, these ICs are programmed in such a way that it shows the data from 0 to 9. Fine. So if somebody says me that you have to display only even number, then I can commit accordingly, or vice versa happens. And speed is high. We have to just write a program and upload the program, and our output device will act like our program. Most importantly, our digital data is highly data, secure, or security is high in digital case, because everything is password protector. We can apply some of the encryption technique for the digital data. So these are the benefits which shows the importance of digital over the analog. Next thing, that how we convert this analog into the digital. As I told you, that we are having the n number of things which are analog in nature, we are the one who converts it into a digital one. So how it happens? If you see this example, there are two systems. One is pink in color, another one is the sky in color. They want to interact with each other, but in order to interact with each other, they have to follow, this path. So there are n number of things which happens within this path. If you see, firstly, in the digital signal, because computer is the device which understand only 1 and 0, fine, binary language. Then there is a device which is known as modem, means something lies here which convert digital into the analog, and then signal passes through the wires which just send the electrical signal from one place to another, and then it is received by this PC. So something happens within modem which converts this digital into the analog. So in the next lecture, we discuss